Chorus Voices, the podcast brought to you by Chorus, a fresh approach to community service. Settle in, listen in, and enjoy the voices who bring you reflections, musings, and stories from our community.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to this edition of Chorus Voices, the first for 2021. I'm Dan Minchin.
And I'm Lou Forster.
And today, Lou, we're going to talk about something really dear to our hearts and very much at the core of the Chorus strategy, I guess, which is about working more locally.
Sure is. And we particularly are going to talk to someone who has been doing some artwork, which is also really close to the things that we've been doing at Chorus for a while now.
Yeah, that's right. So I mean, people who've been listening to Chorus Voices or following our story will know that the story of Chorus is all about a fresh approach to community service. And at the heart of that, we're making some changes in our organisation to work more locally, to sort of have smaller teams who have better connections to their local community and find ways of, I guess, connecting up those networks that may or may not exist and almost become a facilitator in the community and more than a service provider. So there's a lot of change going on right now in Chorus, particularly focused initially in the Peel region. And we'll be working through those changes with staff and potentially some customers in the weeks ahead. But we really wanted to talk a little bit today about where the localism exists already in Chorus. And Lou, it's been a source of inspiration for us for quite a few years now, hasn't it?
It has, and the lady we'll hear from, Elli, has kind of followed that journey all the way through from when we merged the three organisations together to form Chorus. We created a three-piece mosaic, and the customers and staff and lots of people were involved in making that mosaic, and Elli actually did the design for it that had kind of elements of the three brands. So it's really a strong thread through the last few years.
So, look, let's have a listen to Judith's conversation with Elli, where she talks about, you know, the Ability Arts program and how it plugs into the local community in Mandurah.
Elli, tell me what's been going on down at Ability Arts.
We try and have an annual exhibition each year, which is really about showcasing what our guys have been producing and getting it out there in the community to show, you know, other Mandurah people who might be interested in coming along and having a go at Ability Arts, what we do. So we're planning that for later in the year. Hopefully once COVID sort of restrictions are eased and we can get slightly more back to normal. We had a big year last year with community project at Ability Arts is providing opportunities for our customers to contribute to the community and get involved in community projects. So we partnered with the City of Mandurah for International Day of People with Disability, which was in December, and we sent out for expressions of interest from local people living with disability in the Mandurah area to see if they'd be interested in producing a self-portrait. So it was a self-portrait exhibition. And we had 70 participants, which was great. So we sent out a kit with a canvas and paints and paintbrushes and some ideas to get started. And then we had them exhibited at the Performing Arts Centre throughout December last year. So it was a really, really great exhibition. We had lots of good positive feedback. And it's just great to get other people involved in our Ability Arts projects. We could have done it just in-house with our customers, but we thought we'd throw it out to the wider community. And it's really good for building some connections within the community. We had about 25 students from John Tonkin Ed Support Centre take part, so that was really great to get them involved.
So how did they get involved and how did you support them to do that?
So we've put out the expression of interest through the City of Mandurah's inclusion sort of groups and got loads of interest. So I sent out the packs to the school and the teachers there. I don't know if they did them in school or if they took them home and did them. They were all quite different. And they had to write a little story to go with their self-portrait, which was really, really interesting as well. And then we collated them all and exhibited them.
Did you exhibit them down at Ability Arts or was this part of the exhibition that they all went to?
Yeah, so it was at the Mandurah Performing Arts Centre. So it opened for International Day of People with Disability, which I think is December the 3rd. They had the big City of Mandurah event there. So the Ability Arts guys went along. Lots of the artists who'd taken part came along. And it was opened by David Templeman It was a really great day, especially kind of getting a big group of people together last year, towards the end of last year. It was really nice to see that kind of normal interaction going on where we could all get together and mingle. And yeah, so it was really good. It was kind of a positive end to the year. They were mostly Mandurah based. We had a few Rockingham based artists take part as well. So what really led on to that exhibition was the Art Box project we ran earlier in the year. So that's really why the city approached us to run the next project, because it's quite similar. We sent out the boxes. So this was the same kind of thing where we sent out the kits.
So, Elli, I believe you partner with the City of Mandurah for some of these projects.
Ability Arts has been running for, I think, over 10 years. So we've built up a strong relationship with the City of Mandurah and with the Inclusion and Access group and officer there. So it's really nice now that they approach us when projects come along and they think, hey, maybe Ability Arts would like to take part and like to coordinate that. So another project we did last year for them was to produce the signage for the beach access equipment shed, which is down at Keith Holmes Reserve in Mandurah. So all our artists got together and started drawing beach sort of inspired illustrations, which we then put together into a design, which is now on the shed.
I believe you've been working on Containers for Change as well down there.
Yeah, when Containers for Change came out, we thought that would be a great opportunity to make some extra money. And our customers have really gone for it. And they're constantly turning out with bags and bottles and cans. And we've got a big skip bin now at 6 Cumberland Street. So if anyone's down our way and got a few bottles and cans rattling around, we'll take them off you. So it would be great for these sort of other offices and centres get on board with that, because it's so easy. You just get your bin, start collecting, cash them in every couple of weeks, and it builds up.
And do the customers take part in that as well? Ability,
yeah. So they're very proactive in bringing containers in and getting their friends and family to collect for us. And also they then have a say in what we do with that money. So as we save it up, we might, you know, spend it on a special day out somewhere or a party or something. I mean, the other big change we had at Cumberland Street was the other groups moving in with us from our house.
Okay.
So that was a big change last year, but that's actually been a really positive change.
So why did that come about?
So we kind of merged with our house. So the groups they ran out of our house have moved in to Cumberland Street with us. So it's great. It's a lot busier there now. There are lots of groups happening each day, so that's really nice, especially with the NDIS groups like the Divas and the Life Club groups that used to operate out of our house and now with us. And it's really great to see all the groups sort of mingling together at lunch times, and we go on outings together. We went on a dolphin cruise all together last week, which was really nice, and that was paid for with money from artwork sales and fundraising.
It's great you had some really positive stories coming out of 2020. I believe one of your customers did really well in an exhibition last year as well.
Yes, so our artists at Ability Arts always enter the As We Are exhibition up in Perth, which is a statewide exhibition and competition for artists living with an intellectual disability. We had 8 entries this year, which is the most we've ever had. And Kylie Graham, who is one of our newest pottery group members, actually won the Sculpture Award with her sculpture of Cinderella and Prince Charming. So that was great. She was just so, so excited. And she actually received the award from Stephen Dawson, who is the Minister for Disability in WA. So that was just really great to see her so excited. And it really boosted her confidence as well. And she's gone on to make some really amazing artworks. So that was a really good story out of 2020 as well.
Yeah, that is a great story. We'll have to get a photo on the podcast so we can people can look at it too.
So we've got some nice photos, and she also is in the paper, our local paper.
Do you think the connections that you made during the selfie exhibition, those particular groups that you kind of supported to do it, do you think that you'll still continue to work with them this year or be involved with them in any way? Or
yeah, the link we made with John Tonkin at Support Centre was really good, because that's with their sort of year 11, 12 kids, So that's just really great to offer them a little taster of maybe if they come along to Ability Arts and can keep going. If they're into art, you know, it's an opportunity for them to keep going with that side of things. And also we made a great link with the Unsteady Hand art group, who are a Parkinson's support group that actually meet at Cumberland Street, and they use our art room. So that's really great to make a link with them as well. So all these kind of links you make in the community are really valuable, and I think it's really nice to all become connected, sort of access each other's knowledge and resources. So that's been a great outcome.
Yeah, and it's lovely to kind of connect over a common thing like art as well, isn't it? To just be doing that together is really, it's really lovely.
Yeah, yeah, art can be a really good way of getting together. Connecting with people, definitely.
So really enjoyed hearing from Elli and finding out what they've been up to lately down at Ability Arts. And I really like the connection we have with the city of Mandurah in the Peel. I think that's really important. And for going forward, I actually opened an exhibition we had last year in 2020 that had our artists down at Ability Arts. And some of my conversations were really interesting with the artists because they have a range of connections to the community and to Chorus, including one woman who's been a volunteer customer and a staff member and I think has featured on our podcast before. So I think Ability Arts really speaks to the multiple connections and how we really connect with the community down there.
And do you see, Lou, that there's sort of even more potential for a local, locally focused way of working like Ability Arts?
Yeah, I think so, because we've generally had a traditional entry into the Ability Arts program through, you know, the services that people have had either through seniors or disability. And I think with the local model, people that may live in the area but had never thought about arts before will probably get the opportunity to participate because, you know, as part of this local, all of the staff are going to be working together. And it'll be a good opportunity for some of our staff as well. We've got gardeners in the area and they have crossed paths a couple of times. We've had a Ability Art mosaic in one of the gardens at our property that the gardeners also revamped. So we've got some crossover, but I think there's lots of potential for more.
And it's sort of, you know, it sounds like a more natural way of working the way you describe it. People happen to sort of almost form a village around the area that they work in, and that village incorporates customers and other members of the community. And look, really, I think when we sit back from that and think about what this might mean for Chorus as a whole is to try and replicate that. So one of the challenges that community organisations have is as they grow, they can become less personal and more sort of transactional in the way they work. What we're hoping to do at Chorus is to get the benefits of being medium to large size in terms of our ability to provide many services and have, you know, invest in technology and things that make that possible, at the same time as not just preserving but actually strengthening that local way of working. So really what we're trying to do in the Peel area and then beyond is replicate the sort of local way of working that we've heard about today in other places. And that's really the plan.
It is. And while you were talking there, Dan, I was thinking about how we've responded to COVID in 2020 and 21 and how that's given us a little bit of insight into the roll your sleeves up and just get on with it and work together. And we've seen some real local working there. So I think, you know, with our transformation and working in this local way and what we've learned and what we've applied during COVID sets us up for some great success, I think.
Yeah, it does. And, you know, what we've heard today is that what's possible when an organisation is set up to work locally. What may not be so visible to people and maybe a bit more in the background is the different type of organisational setup you need to have. We need to have less bureaucracy. We need to be less focused on where the funding comes from and more focused on the customer. So maybe a episode for another time or a conversation for another episode about sort of what it takes to work like that. But today we've been able to just enjoy some inspiration from right in front of us, the Ability Arts program in Chorus, which has been going for many years and is going from strength to strength.
Absolutely. And we'll look forward to seeing more from them and, like you said, what their connection to Peel will be.
Great. So, look, nice to chat, Lou, and we'll catch you next time.
Yep. See you soon.
Thanks for listening to Chorus Voices, the podcast brought to you by Chorus. If you like our show and wanted to know more, check out our website at chorus.org.au. And please leave a review. We'd love to hear your feedback and it helps others find us and enjoy the podcast as well. Join us next time for more inspiring stories and news from our community. Chorus, a fresh approach to community service.